the phone number. No. Good afternoon again. Thanks, Dr. Saha, for the nice, lovely introduction. Thank you. I will give you a briefing about the latest guidelines in breast cancer screening. In this presentation, I will try to cover the ACR guidelines and the recommendations for breast cancer screening, modality-based and risk-based, to discuss the argument for screening, when to start, when to stop screening, should we have to stop screening after 70, digital mammography or not, the risk assessment tools and the screening of high risk, and we'll give you about us in the Egypt Breast Cancer National Screening Program. And we'll start with the breast cancer screening with imaging recommendations from the Society of Breast Imaging and the American Society of Radiology on the use of mammography, breast MRI, breast ultrasound, and other technologies for detection of clinically occult breast cancer. Screening of breast cancer with mammography has been shown to decrease the mortality from breast cancer, and mammography is the mainstay for screening for clinically occult disease. Mammography, however, has well recognized limitations, and recently other imaging include ultrasound and MRI has been used as an adjuvant to screening tools, mainly for women who may be at increased risk, as Dr. Rocha just mentioned, for the development of breast cancer. The Society of Breast Imaging and Breast Imaging Commission of the ACR are issuing their recommendation to provide guidelines for patients and clinicians on the use of imaging for breast cancer screening, and whenever possible, the recommendations are evidence-based, and whenever not possible, it's a consensus opinion. Starting with the imaging technique or the image-based screening, mammography. First of all, mammography is a good standard for screening and should start at the age of 40 for women with average risk. For women with mothers or sisters with premenopausal breast cancer, yearly starting at the age of 30, but not before the age of 25 or 10 years earlier than the age of youngest affected breast cancer in the family, whichever later. Women with history of mantle radiation after Hodgkin lymphoma receive at the age between the age of 10 and the age of 30 yearly. The mammogram should start 8 years after the exposure to radiation, irrespective of the age, but not to start before 25, because those patients, 40% of these females are exposed to breast cancer 10 years after exposure to radiation for the chest following treatment of Hodgkin lymphoma. Women with biopsy-proven lobular carcinoma, lobular in situ, atypical lobular hyperplasia, atypical ductal hyperplasia, and duct carcinoma in situ, meaning the high-risk lesions, invasive breast cancer, or ovarian cancer, yearly should start the screening irrespective of the age as well. For screening based on the modality, second is the ultrasound, can be considered when having high-risk women for whom MRI screening may be inappropriate but cannot be superior to the MRI. It also can be considered when having dense mammary stroma. You all, of course, know about the ACR classification of breast density, and recently we have multiple articles, including that published in the last RCNA by our professor, Dorea Sell. The heterogeneously dense breast and the extremely dense breast are more exposed to breast cancer. Coming soon to practice the automated breast ultrasound, it has the ability to scan the entire breast. It saves time for the radiologist so that we can screen a large number of cases, including without the attendance of the radiologist, and the images can be viewed by on the screen like the mammography. And I have the honor to announce that we have acquired the 3 automated breast ultrasound machines in the screening program and will be implemented very soon. For the MRI, is MRI proven to have a very important role for BRCA genes the annual screening by MRI should start at the age of 50 in case of gene mutation, and women with 20% life risk, lifetime risk cancer on basis of family history also should start a screening at the age of 30, and also patients with exposure to radiation following Hodgkin lymphoma irrespective of the age, regardless of age. Women with newly diagnosed breast cancer and normal contralateral breast, by conventional imaging and physical examination, simply screening MRI for the contralateral breast at the time of the diagnosis. Also may be considered for women having risk between 15 and 20% lifetime risk for breast cancer on basis of personal history of ovarian cancer or pathologically proven lobular carcinoma or ADH. There are other methods of screening, like maybe you know about there were large number of publications and very few published studies about the thermography, the cystamidi, and the trans-illumination or electric impedance scanning and optical scanning of breast cancer. Of these alternate screening modalities, thermography is the most widely studied. It was initially included in breast cancer detection demonstration project, but dropped after experience during the first 4 years of the project because the sensitivity dropped to 43% only for detection of breast cancer. So the ACR and the SBI do not endorse the mammography for the thermography or any of these other modalities for screening of breast cancer. Screening with other technologies like the tomosynthesis, adding digital breast cancer breast tomosynthesis to the full field digital mammography improves the cancer detection in women with a dense breast by 30% and decrease the recall rate to 37%. So it's important to add tomosynthesis in dense breast. For screening based on the risk factor, for women with average risk, the annual mammogram should start at the age of 40. And for those of the high risk, the BRCA gene mutation and untested first degree relative of BRCA mutation, annual mammogram should start at the age of 30 or 10 years prior to the youngest affected breast cancer female in the family, but not to start before the age of 25. Women with 20% lifetime risk for breast cancer on basis of family history, annual mammogram or annual mammogram and annual MRI should be start, as Dr. Rasha just mentioned, the two together at the age of 30. MRI cannot replace the mammogram because of still the mammography is the only modality to show the microcalcification and the DCIS. So when we start MRI for young, we start it together along with mammography. For personal history of breast cancer, like invasive carcinoma, ovarian carcinoma, and lobular carcinoma, also MRI should be an annual examination. There are arguments and recommendations entitled by the ACR for screening of mammography, including whether to start screening at the age of 40 or above 40, screening with digital mammography or analog is enough, screening of women with mammography before 40 and screening after 70, and screening of high risk and how the risk is being assessed. Evidence support, we start the argument about the screening at the age of 40. Okay, what do you think to start screening at the age of 40 or 50? 40? Egypt. Dr. Mann, 40. Dr. Doreen, 40. Yes. Evidence to support the recommendation for regular periodic screening mammography comes from the results of several randomized controlled trials conducted in Europe and North America, and including the total number of 500,000 women. The trial varied in the age included of women and screening frequency and demonstrated a statistically significant decrease in the mortality of the population who are screened, and on their meta-analysis there is 26% at least reduction in mortality in women screened at the age of 40. And the, moreover, 39% of reduction of the breast cancer mortality when comparing the period before the advent of population-based screening to the period before screening. There has been some controversy about the age to start breast cancer screening, and The meta-analysis supported barring the ACR also include 15% reduction in the mortality for women aged between 40 and 49. Despite this analysis, the American Cancer Force for Breast Cancer Detection concluded that they argue the starting screening at 40 and they want to start screening at the age of 50 and should be biannual. And they concluded in their results that the biannual screening started at the age of 40 would achieve the same results of annual screening with starting at the age of 40, but with substantial less harm. And in their meta-analysis in the year 2009 recommendations, they showed that not only does the recommendation ignore the basic fact of starting screening at 50 with no meaning, there is no direct evidence that screening of women with mammography on basis of individual risk of breast cancer will have the same mortality and the screening of the population. However, the ACR and the SBI firmly stand behind their recommendation for breast cancer screening to start at the age of 40 and for women of average breast cancer risk. So, to screen with digital mammography or film screen, several studies comparing the performance of digital mammography to film screen and they found the equivalent sensitivity between digital mammography and analog mammography. However, digital mammography significantly performed better than analog mammography in premenopausal and premenopausal women, those aged 50 and less, and those with dense breasts. But the ACR and the SBI feel that women should continue to be screened even if the digital mammography is not available in one screen. Randomized controlled studies about starting screening before the age of 40. These randomized trials have been performed to test the impact of screening mammography and mortality reduction in the age population before 40. And because of no data exists for optimal age to start screening mammography in women with increased risk of breast cancer, the recommendations will document based on consensus opinion and not on evidence. Women who undergo breast conservation are exposed to the risk of recurrence at a rate of 1% per year. So when they, after breast conservation, the mammogram should start annually irrespective of the patient age. For any woman with history of breast cancer, previous history of breast cancer, she should perform the mammogram irrespective of the age. Similarly, patients with personal history of ovarian cancer or high-risk lesion, as mentioned before, also should start irrespective of the age. Also, women with history of mediastinal radiation, as I just mentioned, also should start irrespective of the age, but not start the mammogram before the age of 25. And women with high-risk pathologies before, like atypical lobular hyperplasia and atypical ductal hyperplasia, should continue screening irrespective of the age of the discovery of the lesion. When having a gene mutation or cancer related to gene mutation, several genes and numerous mutations have also shown to be responsible about hereditary breast cancer, including the famous BRCA1 and BRCA gene, and they increase the risk of breast cancer from 19 to 85%. So when having positive BRCA genes, the patient should screen with both mammography and MRI annual irrespective of the age, but also not to start before the age of 25. And not only the BRCA genes, there are other genes responsible for breast cancer mutation, including the patent gene associated with Cowden syndrome. You know Cowden syndrome? Cowden syndrome is a multiple fibroadenoma hamartoma syndrome. It may include the renal, the kidney, the breast, the thyroid. And the B53 gene, which is the Lou-Formani syndrome. The Lou-Formani syndrome is an hereditary association of multiple cancers, including the osteosarcoma, the soft tissue sarcoma, and breast cancer, and Muir-Torre. your three is the colon cancer and soft tissue cancer and breast cancer. And the famous Bedger-Jugger syndrome, which is a multiple intestinal papillomatosis and also have increased incidence of breast cancer. Okay. At what age should screening end? Should we have to end screening at 74 or 70? Dr. Ashraf, should we have to stop screening after the age of 70? Okay. There is an argument about that. The Americans say, yes, we stop screening at the age of 70, but if we have, if the lady has a good performance and she can live, we have expected life expectancy more than 8 years, she should continue screening. So women in average age between 70 to 74 and expected to live 13 years later, or between 75 to 79 and expected to live 10 years, come in, and 80 to 84 and expected to live 6, we shouldn't discontinue screening. Given the competing causes of morbidity and mortality associated with the increased age, the ACR and the SBI suggest that screening with mammography should continue as long as the woman have life expectancy from 5 to 7, on basis of age and health status and willing to undergo additional testing, including biopsy, as indicated according to the finding diagnosed, because it decreased the incidence of metastatic breast cancer by 50%. Coming to the risk assessment, we measure the risk. There are multiple methods to measure the risk, including the Gale, Klaus, and Broca assessment tools. The Klaus is the number of relatives in the screen in the family having breast cancer, and the other models include the probability based on the BRCA genes, and the Tyrer-Crookes, which accounts the family and reproductive history of the patient, but none of these models consider the breast density. For women with increased risk, as mentioned many times, it's annual MRI and annual mammogram, and maybe ultrasound if the annual MRI could not be done. With the release of the first results of the Aiken trial, more attention is being paid for the supplementary screening for ultrasound. However, it's time consuming, but in the era of automated ultrasound, it will solve the problem. The screening by ultrasound examination is very beneficial to support the screening in dense women. Last part of the presentation is about the breast cancer screening project, the Women Health Outreach Project, which is an initiative focusing on early detection of breast cancer. The program started in October 2007 and was managed by Dr. Doreya Salem. She is actually the founder and the lady behind this dream. I want to share our I had the honor to follow her in managing the program since September the year 2014 till present. Our mission in the program is to screen or early detect breast cancer among Egyptian women in order to reduce the mortality rate from the disease and to provide the utmost quality of life for the discovered cases, and also to decrease the financial burden of treating breast cancer in the late stage. Our vision is eliminating breast cancer in the discovered and to prevent it being discovered at advanced stage. In the last statistics, the Egyptian women aged between 40 and 70, more than 10 million women, so it's a big task. What we have now is just an opportunity screening. The equipment is not enough for population-based screening, but we are trying. During the period between October 2007 till present, we have already screened 147,000 women were screened for breast cancer, diabetes, hypertension, obesity. The program consists mainly of mobile digital mammography units and static units and the Center of Excellency. This is how the program is designed. the mobile units with the belief of the program and the limited accessibility of the population will never reach its objective until you go for them. So it's an exclusively designed to fulfill the project requirement. Currently we have 10 working units, and this year, alhamdulillah, we added 2 more units in process and will be implemented very soon. And also this year we added 3 units of automated breast ultrasound, and it will be for the first time in the Middle East to start the screening of young with the automated ultrasound, with the automated breast ultrasound. This is how the van looks from inside. And this is the center of excellency where we all work in there, giving the reporting, and we have the structured report was invented and created at the time of Dr. Durraya, and it is a unique one, really. We have all the database, we have all the cases and all the data for statistics and research. We have our website and call center, and we have a recall unit in the center of excellency. We recall the patient with positive findings for ultrasound and biopsy. We have a multidisciplinary clinic that is done 2 times per week with our colleagues from surgery and oncology. We also started the Pink Foundation, which is a recent NGO to support the breast cancer screening program. And the Pink Foundation created the DETECT, which is an initiation of activity. It was the first annual screening, and it will go as annual occasion to support Egyptian women. According to our results, the total number of screen cases at our latest statistics was 143, more than 143, with the positive cases more than 1,600. The incidence of breast cancer in our cases was 0.115 over 1,000. And at the start of screening, I remember when we published the first viral trial about the first year, it was 2.1. So if you consider that these numbers maybe not very accurate, but if we consider the number, we have impact on the community. We have the incidence of breast cancer is relatively decreased. If we compare the result of this year to the result of 2007, the recall rate in our cases is 12%, and the mean size of the tumor is unfortunately 2.4%. It's large for screening, it's large size to be detected by screening, but it reflects our culture and the basis that they could come late. The incidence of interventional procedure in our cases 9%. And the primary screening represents 85% of the screening cases, and the prevalent screening or the follow-up screening is 15%. And these are some pictures from our screening and campaigns. Here was in Aswa, and here in Sejn El Amater. Here me and Laurent in Sejn El Amater. And that was in Rabah. So this poster we can go for. That was in the Ministry of Social Solidarity, and that was also in Aswan, for the marathon in Aswan. And we go for the universities, and we got help by young doctors to arrange campaigns and awareness. And we arrange the training courses in the screening program to support the young doctors in the governorate that help us in the recall units. Finally, the introduction of screening of breast cancer in Egypt was a dream that came true. It will continue to provide the role of primary prevention, early diagnosis and treatment, raising public awareness about the disease, and role of screening in the primary prevention will continue to be the main weapon in the fight of breast cancer. Little hope makes lots of love. We aim at early detection of breast cancer, and we strive to reach every woman in our beloved country. Thank you.
Thank you, Najla. You are always presentable and wonderful. Thank you so much. And now it's time for questions. Any questions for the speakers? I think you are all hurrying. Thank you. Oh, yeah? gone. I think you can use the other one.
The mic? Why this mic?
For whom you for whom? Nadia. Yeah. Question for you. Nadia Bob.
Thank you, Professor Nadia, for your very eloquent two presentations. I want to ask you about any available comparative studies between the results of tests in comparison to operative research and system. As you call local recurrence.
Yes, local recurrence.
Yeah.
As a result of the completeness of excision.
Yes, exactly.
Yes, yeah, but it's not published yet. I will present inshallah in next March in the ECR. It will be about what you are asking exactly, the correlation between the excision of suspicious lesion by blast and the results of open biopsy in similar random study. Actually, the results in comparison to surgery is very promising. The sensitivity in comparison to open biopsy, if we consider the blast as an open biopsy, as a closed biopsy method for complete lesion excision, it is very much comparable to the open biopsy, and especially open biopsy after wire localization, because you can have the margin available for review, and we have multiple cases of breast cancer comes out with free margin. I think we'll start a study with some colleagues to do radiotherapy and sentinel node mapping without surgery.
Well, I want to ask you also about the frequency of the test, if you have. Do you guys have lots of margin?
The frequency?
Frequency. How many times you can release a test that you get that added margin?
We can release it. How can we remove? It's a single excision system. You remove the lesion in one piece. But you mean I can introduce another lesion, a needle, and go another piece in order to be more sure? Yes, of course. Of course, you can do that. Yes.
Thank you.
A question? Any more questions? So.
Excuse me, my question is for Ferran about the post-operative assessment. You advised in the end of the session for contrast enhancement, the mammography and MRI year by year, and year contrast enhancement and another year MRI. I think that with regards to the cases presented in the presentation, where the post-operative recurrence was aggressive in less than 6 months, why we can't use the contrast and constant mammography as a routine?